Great Scott! It's Back to the Future, the musical!
Hey guys, Steve C. here for BackToTheFuture.com here at the historic Pantages Theater in Hollywood, California. In just a short amount of time, the red carpet premiere of the opening of the Los Angeles stop of the Back to the Future musical tour will be happening right here. Cast and crew from the musical itself, as well as cast and crew members from the original Back to the Future film trilogy, will be arriving and making their way into the premiere. We've been invited out to chat with them at this long-awaited and much-anticipated opening right here on Hollywood Boulevard. Well, the DeLoreans are pulling up with a special guest for tonight's premiere, so hey, let's go see what the future has to offer.
A fascinating device here.
Every night you bring Doc Brown alive on the stage around the country, different cities. What is it that you are adding to Doc to make it your own?
The main thing that I think about Doc is that he is he holds on to his childlike wonder. He's still innocent and has no guile and is so excited. He's almost like a 10-year-old boy about, remember when you would do the experiment with the vinegar and make the lava come out of the volcano? That's still amazing to him. And so that's what I try to bring to it, that childlike wonder and innocence.
So what is it about your rendition of Marty McFly? What are you honing in on when you're trying to play Marty?
Ooh. Dang, I don't think I've ever thought about that. I think I love the humor in this. I feel very comfortable with the humor, and those are some of my favorite parts. And also, I really try and breathe and sit in some of the quiet moments. I think those are the real part of the story that really leave people really impacted by the story. And so I really want to make sure that those moments that I think made the movie special and I think make this show really special, really give those their due.
I've never seen purple underwear before, Calvin. Honestly, last night, our first preview here at the Pantages was electric. Marty stepped out onto the stage in uproarious applause for like almost a minute where he couldn't even say his line, and I'll never forget that. You could feel the feedback between the audience and the actor.
What are you looking at, butthead?
What is the takeaway every night when you know that there are Back to the Future fans for almost 40 years out there in the audience? What is your motivation to get out there to perform and be Biff for them?
Yeah, you know, this show is so important to so many different people, and to get to give the gift that is this show to them is really special. And obviously Biff is an iconic guy, and you know, I just go and put my silly wigs and costumes on and go clown around for him. It's the most fun.
You're a slacker, McFly. I've always wanted to tour. As soon as I was a permanent resident of the US, I was like, I want to see the road. I want to see all these different states. And I've been to LA twice before, very briefly, so this is an amazing experience. Yeah.
I actually had an opportunity to audition for the Broadway
show.
Production.
Yes, you did.
And I auditioned as Biff, which is very silly for us all now. And this story has a funny way of coming back around, right? And I was so honored when they called to say, hey, can you actually do George for the tour? And
George definitely makes more sense.
I was going to have to do like a very Guido-esque sort of like undershirt.
Oh, you're going to do something like this?
I was going to do like a little bit like this, like evil and conniving. But yeah, I'm glad it worked out the other way.
Yeah.
So far on this, what have been the most memorable takeaway moments of the musical now that it's in all the different incarnations?
Just seeing it explode in the theater and having the audiences love it. That's what I enjoy the most. Such a great show.
What is it like now to have this here in Hollywood?
It's great. As a matter of fact, one of our locations was right down the street at the church right there on Highland. So it's great to be back here. It's where it belongs.
When you see these actresses on stage portraying that character of Lorraine, is there any sense of nostalgia? Is there a sense of...
You know, I thought I'd be really upset about it, but now it's really fun to have seen... Now I'm going to see the third person do it. And it's just fun, the legacy of it. It's what's interesting is that the actors have found a way to kind of like carry the spirit of us, but not... of our characters, but not imitate us.
Right.
But I was happy that Lorraine was still really horny.
What is it like having the musical now back home, basically?
Well, it's interesting because we've both seen the musical both in London and on Broadway. So this is a national tour, and I got to see it in Minneapolis, which is where I live. And it's so fascinating because you're talking about a transition from a movie to a musical, but it's how the movie as an event is on the stage, and the music just makes sense when you see it. There's also so much energy about it being here, I think, that people have been waiting for a long time. Everybody wanted there to be Back to the Future 4. I think this is a much better
this
idea.
This is Back to the Future 4.
I've seen it 4 times in London and once on Broadway, and I'm the biggest fan. Anything that I can do to support Back to the Future, the franchise, I'm first in line.
You again?
Oh my God, well, I hope that's not the bad you again.
It's the good you again.
Okay, good, thank you. All right, we were just minutes away from where the musical was written here, finally back home in Hollywood. What is this moment like now?
It's somewhat surreal, but at the same time, it's such a great celebration for us because, I mean, we're kind of like, on some level, products of Hollywood. The movie Back to the Future is such an iconic movie, and the fact that now we have another iteration of it called Back to the Future the Musical, I just feel like I've died and gone to heaven, but here we are, and I'm still here.
And Alan, what do you think about this, being here now?
Well, you know, it's amazing. I mean, Glenn he has such humility, but Glenn has brought so much to Back to the Future, and to allow this to happen, this new incarnation, if you will, of Back to the Future, that, you know, we have a new brother. We didn't even know we had back in 85, but we had one, and it was great getting to meet him, and now we're going on this journey for the rest of our lives together, and it's magnificent.
Did I think it would be a musical 40 years later?
No.
Absolutely not.
No.
But the one thing that I love about Mr. Bob Gale is that he gave Goldie Wilson a song. And I like the sound of that.
Yes.
Is there one scene in the musical here that you're looking forward to seeing how they took something that you did on the screen and now how they're going to transform it?
There's so much fun in Back to the Future that I think almost any scene lends itself to a musical expression. So this is a great delight to see something I've worked on turned into a musical.
What is it about now with a national tour that's exciting you the most, that we're expanding beyond, you know, and bringing it to people all around the country?
We always saw the U.S. tour as being the home of the show. And what's the most exciting thing is that around 40% of the people that are coming are not regular theater goers. So we're really breaking into people who don't normally go to musicals. That's exciting. It's good for the industry as well because people are coming and enjoying shows. Maybe they'll go see another musical afterwards. So they're just ordinary people enjoying the show, and that's really what our show's about.
Well, I just got out of Back to the Future the Musical right here at the Hollywood Pantages Theater. I think this cast did a great job.
Great, Scott. This is the third place I've seen it. I've seen it in London. I've seen it in New York. And it just gets better and better. And I feel so lucky as a lifelong Back to the Future fan that I even get to be here on opening night. And I don't know why Back to the Future is not a national holiday yet.
I was blown away at how they could tell a story in a different medium in 2.5 hours. Bob Gale and Bob Zemeckis, absolute genius is how you could put this into a musical and make it work. Absolutely incredible. If you haven't seen it, get your buns down and do it.
It was so good. I thought everybody's performance was amazing. It was so good. They were all like so amazing. I was like, yes! I was like the loudest one clapping. I was like, yes!
It was a great cast, great music, great storyline.
It literally was Broadway. It was Broadway, in my opinion.
Perfection.
It was so amazing. So amazing. Perfection. Yeah. Go see it now. Go see it now.
This is my first time seeing the musical. It's fantastic to be here on opening night in Hollywood, the greatest place in the world.
Loved it. It was amazing for me to share something from my childhood with my son.
I love the little changes that they've made. I've seen the movie hundreds of times. I'm a huge fan. And the DeLorean, on a stage, it's incredible. It's so awesome.
It's fantastic seeing all the wonderful things that they adapted from the film to the theatrical version. So that's the reason to come see this play.
Definitely a very, very, very like amazing experience for Back to the Future fans.
We just saw Back to the Future the musical, and it's incredible.
Yeah, and we're loving it.
It's really good. I really like how funny it is.
The special effects are amazing.
Yeah. Like, oh my gosh, the really car. Cool.
Yeah.
It's incredible.
It was awesome. I mean, it's like an alternate version of the movie, like an alternate timeline. It has a lot of the original elements, but it also has a whole new side to it with the music and dance numbers and everything. So it was a lot of fun. I highly recommend everybody see it.
Is there any one particular thing about Back to the Future that brings you joy when you think about it? A certain scene, a character?
The concert, and he's disappearing from the picture, just the tension of that moment, and trying to play the guitar and all that kind of business. I always kind of go back to that one, I guess.
Yeah, it's a good one.
I was surprised. How are they going to turn this into a musical? How are they going to get the car on stage or the clock tower? It's a huge play. Definitely imaginative.
As a fan and a first timer, loved it. I grew up with the movie. I cherished the movie. I actually used to work at Back to the Future the Ride, rocking the shirt. It was so fun, so fantastic. Love the energy, love the music. Just come in, enjoy the moment, enjoy the experience, and you're gonna have a great time.
What a historic opening for the Back to the Future musical on its national tour stop here in Los Angeles. We talked the cast and crew for the musical itself, as well as the 1985 movie, and the continued excitement and enthusiasm not only about this show, but for Back to the Future is enough to power 100 DeLoreans and drive us at 88 miles per hour straight into next year's 40th anniversary of the original 1985 film. We were also invited to the opening night party following the show, where cast from both the film and the musical mingled, posed for pictures, exchanged stories, and created memories that will last far into the future. We hope you enjoyed being our McFly on the wall and reminding you to head to Back to the Future musical to find a time and date that this spectacular production will be coming to your town or city in the future. Don't forget to also head on over to backtothefuture.com, your one-stop shop for everything from news, updates, and officially licensed merchandise from your favorite film trilogy. On the scene from the Pantages Theater here in Hollywood, California, I'm Steve Czarnecki for backtothefuture.com. Remember, the future's what you make of it, so make it a good one, all of you.
If I close my eyes and leave this world tomorrow, I'd ask Doc Brown to take that time machine that flies. I'd say, hey Doc, why don't you pop the top and take me for a spin? Let's travel back in time and fly the friendly skies.